गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर सोशल साइंस पोर्शन ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 1, द अर्थ इन द सोलर सिस्टम. मीन्स व्हाट इज द पोजिशन ऑफ अर्थ इन अवर सोलर सिस्टम एंड व्हाट इज सोलर सिस्टम. इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर रीडिंग अबाउट सोलर सिस्टम एंड ऑल द थिंग्स दैट वी कैन सी इन द स्काई. हाउ वंडरफुल इट इज टू वॉच द स्काई आफ्टर सनसेट. वन वुड फर्स्ट नोटिस वन और टू ब्राइट डॉट्स शाइनिंग इन द स्काई. Soon you would see the number increasing. You cannot count them anymore. The whole sky is filled with tiny shining objects. Some are bright, other dim. It seems as if the sky is studded with diamond. They all appear to be twinkling, but if you look at them carefully, you will notice that some of them do not twinkle as other do. They simply glow without any flicker, just as the moon shines. Means if you are seeing in the night at the night sky, you can see many dots object. They are flickering and shining, but some are flickering and some are not shining. They are fixed. Along with these bright objects, you may also see the moon on most of the days. It may, however, appear at different times in different shapes and at different positions. You can see the full moon only once in about a month's time. It is full moon night or Purnima. A fortnight later, you cannot see it at all. It is a new moon night or Amavasya. On this day, you can watch the night sky best, provided it is a clear night. Means when you see the sky, there is a moon, and moon is not in a fixed shape, fixed size. It is changing day by day. So when you saw full moon, it is full moon night, or we call Purnima. And after fortnight, means after 15 days, you can see there is no moon, means a new moon night. It is called Amavasya. At Amavasya, we can see sky is very clear and other objects we can see easily. In next paragraph, do you wonder why cannot we see the moon and all those bright tiny objects during daytime? It is because the very bright light of the sun does not allow us to see all these bright objects of the night sky. Can you understand that when we see in the night, you can see all the objects like stars, moon, but in daytime where they are going, means wo sab kahan chale jate hain in daytime. So there is sunlight that is very bright, so we can't see all the objects that we can see in the night time. The sun, the moon and all those objects shining in the night sky are called celestial bodies. Means all these sun, moon and other objects we can see in the sky at the night time, these are called our celestial bodies. Means celestial bodies, as example sun, moon, stars and other all shining objects we can see in the sky. Some celestial bodies are very big and hot. They are made up of gases. They have their own heat and light, which they emit in large amount. These celestial bodies are called stars. The sun is a star. Means some celestial bodies have their own heat and light. Some have their own heat and light. They are called stars. Our sun is also a star because sun has their own heat and light. But some stars not having their heat and light, they are shining with the other object, means light of other object. Countless twinkling stars in the night sky are similar to the sun, but we do not feel their heat or light, and they look so tiny because they are very very far from us. Means sun is near from the earth, but stars are very far from the earth. So we can see stars in a very tiny form, and sun is near the earth, so we see the large shape of the sun. मीन्स जो चीज़ें हमारे नियर हैं, हम उनको पास से अगर देख सकते हैं तो वो हमें लार्ज फॉर्म में दिखाई देते हैं, बट इफ़ दे आर फार, दे वी कैन सी दे आर वेरी स्मॉल, बट इट नॉट लाइक अगर मैं एक एग्जांपल के लिए लूँ कि कोई भी ऑब्जेक्ट है जो मैं आपको पास से दिखाती हूँ और वो ऑब्जेक्ट आपको बिग दिखाई देगा, बट सेम ऑब्जेक्ट को अगर मैं बहुत डिस्टेंस से दिखाती हूँ तो आपको वो एक छोटा सा दिखाई देगा, मीन्स टाइनी। बट क्या उसका शेप चेंज हुआ? नहीं, शेप वही सेम है, बट वो डिस्टेंस की वजह से हमें टाइनी, स्मॉल या फिर लार्ज दिखाई देता है। नाउ इन नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ, यू मस्ट हैव नोटिस दैट ऑल ऑब्जेक्ट्स लुक स्मॉलर व्हेन सी फ्रॉम आर डिस्टेंस, मीन्स व्हेन वी सी सम ऑब्जेक्ट्स फ्रॉम द डिस्टेंस इट इज लुक स्मॉलर। हाउ स्मॉल एन एरोप्लेन लुक्स व्हेन इट इज फ्लाइंग एट अ ग्रेट हाइट, मीन्स वी कैन सी एरोप्लेन, एग्जैक्ट शेप ऑफ द एरोप्लेन इज एग्जैक्टली नॉट दैट वी कैन सी इन द स्काई। While watching the night sky, you may notice various patterns formed by different groups of stars. These are called constellation. Means there is a question, what is constellation? Constellations means group of stars that is various form and shapes. Ursa Major or Big Bear is one such constellation. One of the most easily recognizable constellation is the Saptarishi. Means these are the examples of constellation. Ursa Major or Big Bear and second is Saptarishi. It is a group of seven star, means Saptarishi is a group of seven star. That's why it's called Saptarishi constellation. That forms a part of Ursa Major constellation and Saptarishi is a part of Ursa Major constellation. Ask someone elder in your family or neighborhood to show you more stars, planets and constellation in the sky. In ancient times, people used to determine direction during the night with the help of stars. The north star indicates the north direction. It is also called the pole star. It is always remain in the same position in the sky. We can found north at the direction of north, there is pole star. An ancient time means long year ago, people are find direction during the night time to find out the pole star or north direction. We can locate the position of the pole star with the help of the Saptarishi. Look at figure 1.1. You will notice that if an imaginary line is drawn joining the pointer stars and extend further, it will point to the pole star. As you can see in this picture, there is a Saptarishi constellation, and in an imaginary line is drawn, there is a brighting star in north, is pole star or north star, it is the north direction. Next, some celestial bodies do not have their own heat and line. As we are read in first or second paragraph, that some celestial bodies, they have not their light and heat, they are lit with the light of the star. Such bodies are called planets, means all the celestial bodies do not have their own heat and light, they are brightened through the other objects for heat and light. They are called planets, means all the planets, they are not having their own heat and light, they are lit by the other stars. The word planet comes from the Greek word planetai, which means wanderers. The earth on which we live is a planet, means the earth is a planet, we all know very well. We are living on the earth, it is a planet, and planet word is coming from the Greek word planetai, which means wanderer. Wanderer means moving. Which is our nearest star? If it gets all its heat and light from the sun, and earth gets all heat and light from the sun, which is our the nearest star? If we look at the earth from a great distance, say the moon, it will appear to be shining just as the moon. Means when we see earth from the great distance, so we can see that earth is also shining like the moon. The moon that we see in the sky is a satellite. It is a companion of our earth and moves around it like our earth. There are seven other planets that gets heat and light from the sun. Some of them some of them have their moons too. Means moons is a satellite of the earth, and many of the planets, they are getting heat and light from the sun. They are 7. So our solar system consists how many planets? There are 8 planets including earth. Now next paragraph we read about the solar system. What is our solar system? The sun, 8 planets, satellites and some other celestial bodies known as asteroids and meteoroids. Means solar system consists sun, all 8 planets, other satellite and other celestial bodies who are shining, and asteroids and meteoroids. These all are consist of our solar system. As we can saw in the picture of solar system, you can easily recognize there is sun, and after that Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, after that Jupiter, Saturn and Uranus, Neptune. These all are 8 planets which are getting heat and light from the sun. There is some thing like asteroid belt. What is asteroid belt? We are learn in next paragraph. What is asteroid? Asteroid means क्या होता है वो हम next paragraph में read करेंगे. यहाँ पर हमें जो 8 planets हैं उनके नाम याद रखने हैं, उसके लिए एक easy sentence भी दिया हुआ है, वो हम देखेंगे. From the solar system, we often call it is a solar family which with the sun as its head. Means these 8 planets consist the solar family, so we are called it is solar family, and sun is the head of this family. Now the sun is in the center of the solar system. As we see in last picture, sun is in the center of the all 8 planets. So there is the sun is in the center of the solar system. It is huge and made up of extremely hot gases. Means how the made sun? So we can say the sun is very huge and it is made up from the extreme gases. Means it is a mixture of gases. It provides the pulling force that binds the solar system. The sun is the ultimate source of the heat and light for the solar system. We all know that sun is have own light and heat that is very extreme, and it is made by the gases that is very extreme gases and pulling force to each other. These all gases are pulling force to each other, but that tremendous heat is not felt so much by us because despite being our nearest star, it is far away from us. The sun is about 150 million kilometer away from the earth. Means एक question यहाँ पे बन सकता है कि earth है वो sun से कितनी दूर है, तो यहाँ पर answer होगा 150 million kilometer. और हमारी जो अर्थ और सन के बीच का जो डिफरेंस है, मीन्स जो डिस्टेंस है, वो उतनी है कि सन की जो हीट और लाइट, इतनी एक्सट्रीम हीट और लाइट होने के बाद भी अर्थ पर उतनी ज़्यादा हीट नहीं होती है. इट इज़ समटाइम कोल्ड, समटाइम हॉट. सो बिकॉज ऑफ द डिस्टेंस. नाउ नेक्स्ट प्लैनेट. There are 8 planets in our solar system in order of their distance from the sun. Means हमारे solar system में how many planets are there? There are 8 planets. The name of these 8 planets, they are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. These all are 8 planets name, and we can easily learn through a sentence. This sentence is my very efficient mother just served us nuts. Means first letter of each word, it is M V E M J S U N. Means M for Mercury, V for Venus, E for Earth, M for Mars, J for Jupiter and S for Saturn, U for Uranus and N for Neptune. These all are name of the 8 planets. All the 8 planets of the solar system move around the sun in fixed path. Means all these 8 planets are moving around the sun in a fixed path or in a fixed way. This way is called orbits. Means all the planets which are moving around the sun in a fixed path, these path are called orbits. Means ये सारे जो planets हैं वो जो move कर रहे हैं जिस path पर, एक fixed path होता है जिस पर move कर रहे हैं उसे हम orbit कहते हैं. Mercury is nearest to the sun. As we saw in the picture that Mercury is the nearest star of the, nearest planet of the sun. It takes only about 88 days to complete one round along the, along its orbit. Means Mercury has completed one round of the sun. It is 88 days. Venus is considered as Earth's twin because its size and shape are very much similar to that of the Earth. Means Venus है उसको Earth का twins कहा जाता है because of कि उसका shape और size same है जैसा कि Earth का है. Means हम twins, what is twins? Twins they are looking like each other. Means वो एक दूसरे के जैसे दिखते हैं, similar दिखते हैं, वही हम twins कहते हैं. तो Venus है और Earth जो है वो दोनों twins के जैसे दिखते हैं because उनका shape और size same है. Till recently, August 2006, Pluto was also considered as a planet. Means 2006 तक हमारे जो solar system है, there is 9 planet. But after August 2006, there is a planet which is called dwarf planet. Means however, in a meeting of the International Astronomical Union, a discussion was taken that Pluto like other celestial object. Means Pluto is our 9th planets of our solar system at the till date August 2006. Means August 2006 तक Pluto को भी planet के जैसे count करते थे, but कुछ time बाद August 2006 के बाद उसको एक other celestial bodies के जैसे ही count करने लगे, जिसकी वजह से उसका नाम था dwarf planet. Means all the planets, जो planets एक celestial bodies की तरह ही count होते हैं, तो Pluto अभी हमारे solar system में हम काउंट नहीं करते हैं. प्लूटो इज द ड्वार्फ प्लैनेट. ये हमें एमसीक्यू के लिए याद रखना है. आगे हम नेक्स्ट वीडियो में देखेंगे द अर्थ, यहाँ से स्टार्ट करेंगे. ओके.